Jay Shrek, I tell you what, here we are again. We're out in it. We're in Agua Fria today. We had a meetup. We have a meetup. And guess what? We're going to one of the most legendary ruin sites on the Agua Fria, Perry Mesa, the monument, they call it. And we are up here in an area right now, if you look across this field. Now, what appears to be just a field, a barren field, was a place, if you were here 500, 600, maybe 800 years ago, what you might have witnessed would be a tournament. A tournament, you say? What kind of tournament would that be? Well, they have an ancient racetrack here where they would have competed for not only spiritual beliefs, but also competition, which they believe they used to wager. So they gambled. Well, yes, they did. They did gamble. And we're going to go to one of those locations where there would have been a racetrack. We're at the legendary Squaw Peak walking along the ridgeline. It goes right across here and around to the ruins that are here. Up here on this mountain right here is a lookout. Because on this mesa, on all the major points, are pueblos. And what they did was they defended this mesa on all corners. Now, what's incredible about that is they call this the tradition, because there were multiple cultures here, not just one. So what's incredible about that is this. The ancient people are basically telling us to be careful in our future. What might you mean that? What might I mean by that? You know, we have to find a common ground, a common goal, a common solution to bond together just like they did up here, right? As we get into these times of difficulty with, you know, people have different opinions about everything, and you know, there's nothing wrong with that. But there needs to be a common ground. And what they found up here was their safety was their common ground. And even though they didn't agree on everything, they agreed that their safety was most important, right? And so, why is that any different than it is today? And one of the reasons that they held their groups together, not only for safety, is there was one common denominator they all had in common that they believed was important, and that they could lay down their weapons and their tools to agree that sport on the mesa was important. And that's why it's important today to understand that things like sport can bring us together. So we don't ever want to politicize our sports, because there are very few things left on this earth that we can all agree on, that we can all believe that our team, our group, our peoples, you know, need to succeed. And if we politicize that, then all of a sudden, we have less things to maybe be in common, have in common, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to look for some of the coolest things out here. Now, Squaw Peak is just an absolute unbelievable area. Now, if you look out here where John's bringing the truck up through here, what you're going to see is they would have had roasting pits, all kinds of different things that activities, working, grinding, hunting. And right now, we're on an ancient racetrack as we speak, where they would have competed right through here. So hundreds of years ago, ancient warriors would be racing down here. And you know, who knows what the prize really would have been. I mean, the reality of it is, it could have been life or death. The gamble could have been gambling for their life. Let's pick a ride up with this guy here, even though I wouldn't suggest that if you're, you know, I wouldn't suggest that to everybody, but I think I'm...
Are you a wonder boy?
Come along. Hey, let's get in the truck. Thank you. One of the most incredible things about Squaw is that they had a perimeter wall. Now, this is what you would have had to try to come up if you were going to try to attack them from the east. You would have had to make it up this hill right here. Now, if you decide you were going to come across the other end, what you would have had was this wall here that would have been a protection wall, which would have been, you know, a hell of a lot higher than it is right now, right through here, right? And it goes the entire perimeter. So if you look anywhere along this cliff wall down through here, what you will find is petroglyphs all the way through here. Now there's ruins on all the different sides, so it's really pretty spectacular through here as you go down. And you look, and look at that petroglyph right there. Even that basic petroglyph there is pretty spectacular. And they are all over. If you follow this ridge line across, you will find stuff all the way through here, and it's just amazing. Look at the view here. Look how incredible that is. Now, if you was here on a weekend or a weekday, you wouldn't see anybody. Now, today we expect to see a few people. We're on a journey, so it's really a beautiful, spectacular place. Look at that ridge line right there. What you're going to see is we're going to come down through here, go down this small trail right here. There were some very interesting grooves in that rocks back there that kind of had my attention, because I believe that they look like it was steel that grooved it, not any other material. So that would have definitely been a different time area, you know, when steel was even in this area. Would have been, you know, more modern ancients, if that makes any sense. And so here's the trail we're going to be walking down right here, right? And we're going to take a look and see if there's anything up on these walls right here. Trail goes a couple different ways, so I think we'll go down and then around and see if there's anything down in here. There's a few small ones up on that ridge, but we know that we're going to see the infamous red deer, which is one of the most famous pictographs that are in this area. Oh, I shouldn't be falling down already. A little early for that. So we've got some stuff up here, but we're looking for specifics this time around. The nice thing is the rain has definitely given us a little more stability in the walking, where it would have been a lot more slick. It's definitely given us a little stability. I think I need to walk up that ridge just to see if I can spot the glyph that we're looking for specifically. Tell you what, I gotta get my sea legs going here. I tell you, there is a lot of different stuff to see already as you come through here. There are stuff all over these rocks. Now, Agua Fria is the home of what I call the oh shit rocks. I believe this is where I coined that. There's some pretty magnificent animals right here. There's a nice guy right there throwing something. Nice deer. Squaw Peak is a place that most people don't realize that It is the home to the oh shit rock. And so that's why you better be careful when you're stepping down and watching this stuff. You know, you look at that. Look at that. Look at that cliff down there. Isn't that incredible? I mean, you just wouldn't think it'd be down there in this corner. You know, a guy laid on the ground and built that right in this area. I just, every time I see stuff like that, it just fascinates me. I just can't get over it. Look at all these shards. And the shards here are just incredible. The shards are just unbelievable. The amount of shards. Yeah, they're up in this ridge. Yeah, they really are. I'm looking for the infamous death. Death is right. So what's going on up here? I don't see anything just yet that it looks like what we want, what we're looking for. So we're gonna take a look. You know, I'm not, it's not hit me. It definitely appears to be a pretty good mix of different eras. You know, we got some archaic stuff in here as well, mixed in. So, I mean, oh, she's beautiful. I mean, it's just good stuff.
I'm John.
It's John up there on the rock. Look how high he is.
I'm doing what I do best. Sending pictures to my wife.
I'm going to walk on around this point and see if we can't find something interesting down here. I walked it before, but it's been a while. Yeah, there's some stuff. There's some good stuff. Yeah. There's some good stuff. Now, I don't know how far it goes, but there's definitely some good stuff on that rock rim. Now, that's a shard right there. That's a shard. That's incredible. Look at that piece right there. And there's the piece that goes with it right there. That's pretty neat.
Yeah, you know, Jeff, you know what we haven't done?
What?
Right there.
Walking that grooves.
Just walk another level, see what's on the rocks right in front of you.
Because there's stuff on those rocks on the top right there.
Yeah, so there might be stuff in the front looking down on the valley.
Because, I mean, we got it all over here. We're seeing stuff, not a ton, but definitely rocks there, definitely. And the shards are getting bigger on this ridge right through here. Now look at that one right there. Tell you what, Neil, look at these big ones like that. It's incredible. It's just incredible. So I guarantee you, as you go down the hill, the shard size are definitely going to increase as we look through here. We walk this ridge. I tell you, extremely steep through here. And again, this is the home, I believe, of the first time I connected rocks with oh shit, if I'm thinking correctly. This is the first time. Now, in the summer, when you're walking these ridge lines, this grass is so slick that you will. Now look at this. These shards like this size are just laying here. I mean, those are big chunky slot. Those are big chunks. That's a rock there. That's a tool right there. That's definitely a tool. Here's a piece of tool right here. It's definitely been worked. Definitely, that ridge, it definitely looks like a piece that's been worked. You definitely can see that right there. You know, it's good to be back in Squaw. It's good to bring people out here to enjoy this and to see this magnificent place. Look right there on that rock right there. Wow. Be that old. See that beautiful wall up there where they had a wall around the outside? Yeah. Yeah. It goes all the way around. Look at that nice tail on that lizard right there.
I know.
Look at that beautiful stuff on that wall. Look at that grouping of people up there. That's pretty cool. Oh, look at that piece. That's another level right there. Well, this is stuff that I haven't seen. I mean, this is a different, look at that piece right there. That's incredible. And these right here, these little smaller.
You gotta have some skills to make it on the rock also. Adults, people holding a kid right there, the little, that's my imagination.
Could be getting ready to throw the kid off the wall. Oh, now what's this one? What's the, oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, this has been as good a place as any, I think. That's pretty incredible right there. I'm going to tell you what, that's pretty incredible. I love that. I just love that piece out. So
it's like a cauliflower. Different cultures, like you see, some of them are really faded, those petroglyphs. Some of them are like, you know, like fresh.
See, and there's a nice set of them up here as well. See, right here. I love the big hand. I got one big hand. You ain't got multiple. So well, now it's not really a hand like you think.
I never saw it.
He's got one big hand. Everybody's having fun. I tell you what, you know what? And who would want to keep this to themselves? I mean, come on. I mean, this is for everybody. Look how excited everybody gets when they get to see this stuff. This is unbelievable. It really is. Now, they would have came out from the Pueblo right here and popped out of this and came down. Here's another of the famous deers right here. Big horns. Might have been in a tourist state of mind. But I mean, how incredible is this? And I love those walls. Imagine what this place would have looked like new, you know. Look at that stack wall there that's 800 years old. You know, they placed it 800 years old. That's incredible.
Mesa, you know.
But it's a little dangerous, too.
No, she would be in the paradise right now. She was four when we did, we had a...
Right there. It was on that one?
Yeah.
Look at that ridgeline, isn't that beautiful? And then you turn that corner and boom, there you are again. Right in the middle of it. Every corner you turn around, you get something of this. But you gotta really walk the, you really gotta walk the ridgeline to really see this stuff. You gotta get down in it. It's like some lizards. Wow, look how cool that is. See, somebody tried to steal those, which is a shame. That's exactly what that is. Somebody tried to beat it off that wall. And then again, you just look down. That actually came off that. How good, that was a beautiful piece too that we got, we lost. I mean, I know you want them, but don't take them. Can't get them off and then you ruin it for everybody. You know, leave them be. You know, if you want petroglyphs, make your own. You know, I'll make a video on how to do that if you want to make your own. So go out in the desert, get you a rock and build your own if you want them. Don't tear the ones up that are here that are, it's our culture. You know, we talked a little bit about how important sport is in this world. It really is. It was a way for the ancients to get away from their world. You know, running was the key to their life, right? Everything that had anything to do with the quality of life was your physicality. So how strong you were, how fast you were. They would make, you know, young boys get up and just run, right? Because it was all about your physicality. And because it was how difficult it would have been to be chasing game. How physical that would have been. So your, you know, ferocity, I guess you say, would be dependent a lot on just your physical being. And, you know, the fastest runners would definitely be the people, or the greatest hunters would be the superstars or the rock stars of that era. And, you know, just like right now, as we politicize sports, you know, we take one thing that might have been something that could have melded the cultures together, and we divide it again. So stop doing that. You know, if modern sports today thinks that they need to be political, I totally disagree. It's one, there's certain things you need to just leave alone, whether it be religious, just like the ancients. They kept their religious and their sporting events completely separate from their beliefs, right? And the cultures between them. That didn't mean they didn't compete against each other, but they didn't have to, you know, draw that line where you couldn't cheer for your home opponent, right? You couldn't have a spiritual connection, or you couldn't have pride, team pride, I guess you could say. So I just think it's important that we don't do that. You know, we kept that stuff separate and we bond together on what we believe to be the best for all of us. And that is that, first off, we, you know, you're safe. If you're not safe, what the hell does it even matter? Any of this matter? So I just see that the ancients, they got together and for one reason, right? To be able to protect themselves, to have an opportunity to live their lives. And then they competed against each other. And I think that's very healthy. But what a beautiful place this is. This is spectacular. Look at that ridge over there. Tell me that isn't unreal. Squaw is just a magnificent place. It really is. You know, when you look at a place like Squaw, and you see that right here, up next to John, there's the point up there on the top, right? But the reality of it is look at how many shards. There's millions of pieces of shard here, which means basically that how much culture and how much life that they lived here. It's incredible, it really is. that how much time they spent in these locations is unbelievable. You know, if you like doing this, we do this quite, you know, we're trying to do it once a month. So, I mean, you know what, if you want to go out and you're not used to it and, you know, you're not used to doing this stuff, it's a really good opportunity to get to come out and experience without doing it yourself. A lot of times we were crazy and did it ourselves, and that's not always the best way to do it. So if you want to, you know, get your feet wet and come through here, Joe just stepped on a no shit rock. I heard it. That's got the most distinctive sound. The first sound is that rock dropping. The second is your stomach dropping that goes with it.
That was the rock that I stood on.
Nice deer down there by John. No, I think it's farther down. Well, everybody made it, or is making it up the hill. Jim and Wendy and Tom, and Joe B's on the bottom. He's making a route to the bottom. Here's that. You could climb down to it, so it's got to be over where it gets flatter over there. That's where it's got to be, Tom.
By the tree?
Yes, I believe it was a tree. If I always mark everything by like a natural. Yeah. There is the infamous red deer of Agua Fria and infamous Squaw Peak, Squaw, actually Creek, really. But look at those. To think that those have been painted years ago. So that's a combination of a petroglyph and a pictograph, which is pretty incredible. Yeah, go, okay, I will walk you.
That's like where Jeff is standing. You can come here.
I can't remember the other guy's name.
Joe.
Joe.
Joe's down below. He walked around. He didn't come up.
No, I lost him altogether. James. He's still down there?
Yeah. It's me, James. Oh, okay. That was the first time I came.
He's coming up from the bottom. Oh, there he is. There he is. He's right under all these precariously hanging rocks.
You know, I've always been fascinated about the wall that's around Squaw. It's always been something that just was incredible to me. I still look at these walls and think that, you know, they're 800 years old. I mean, what do they build for it to last 800 years? Wall? I mean, it's amazing to me. It really is when I see this. And I look around up here and I'm in awe of this place. I mean, it's such a special place. And today, you know, we come out here normally during the week and there's no one. So if you don't like people, that's a good time. But if you do like people, you feel more comfortable on the road with more people. There are a lot of people here on the weekends. If you go to the weekends, I mean, you're gonna see, we see like five different people, and that's unbelievable. You know, you never hardly see any of that. But if you get in here, you look around, it's really an incredible place. Make sure you stay off the walls, but you can look across here and know that they had these walls that went around, and it was really a special, special place. Coming through here. There were people here for 1,000 years. They all weren't in the area, but I still look at these walls, like these walls right here, and it still amazes me at how nice and clean that wall is over here and over there. And that they were all over up here. Let's see if we see Joe B down there. I don't see him, but there he is. He's coming around the ridge. He's walking that ridge line right there. Working his way through. You know, he saw the red deer. That's one of the most famous petroglyphs out here. It's not my favorite. I probably have to still say Man on Fire is my favorite, but you know, as far as challenging as Pado, the duck, right? Has definitely been unique. But you know, you get in here and it's just an unbelievable place. Now, one thing you see is when you look at these ruins right here. Now, there are bones in some of these, leave them alone. So, anytime you see these corners dug, you know, the pot hunters knew that. Well, and then I look at this. Now here's an old one right here. That's an old one. Now that's a, you know, the old opener with the point on it. So probably the people that dug this.
We're digging?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You'll find shovels at some of these old, I mean, ancient shovels. When I say ancient, 80 years old.
Right.
You know. Yeah, yeah. We've looked at Squaw. I think everybody's had a great time. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. You know, if you want to come do these adventures, we do them probably every other month's a fair thing to do. And all you got to do is get on Black Flag Expedition, the area. Now, they do limit the amount of people that come out here. It's free. There's no charge. We do this. We're not a tour. We just do it because we love it. And we show people that are interested in what we're in. And it is limited the amount of people because you don't want 20 cars on the road. And you don't want 20 people into these places because it just, you know, we want to make sure that we protect and preserve it. So if you'd like to come along, join Black Flag on Facebook. We have a YouTube page as well. It's under Ed Psychotic, but we have Black Flag along with it. So, you know, it's a great place. It's a wonderful place. It's a good time. So if you love this stuff, I think everybody's having fun today. So I'm glad you come on. Now we're going to Brooklyn. So we're gonna not just be done here. We're gonna move on down and see some more stuff today. It's gonna be awesome.